Welcome back to Decentralized Nutrition in the Frame, Lens, and Context of Inaccessibility and Economics. This is yet once again a vlog self-journaling update within first-person addressing perspective at enlightening you, readers and viewers, over my very first dosage of Novavax, which was taking place initially back since 21st of February 2022. Once again, as a TLDR, I am pleased to find that, yes, in spite of the fact that there may yet be some question marks surrounding the metabolic markers that may or may not be, once again, under suspicion and or under scrutiny, whether or not such is related to the side effects of vaccine, may yet be remain inconclusive at this stage. However, as a gross summary, I am happy to report that I am not experiencing any sort of pathological or unusual levels of inflammation, discomfort, in that I am finding it very difficult to pinpoint, if any, events, insights, and or markers that may be, that I can actually attribute and or make a initial suspect other than the metabolic markers to the Novavax vaccination itself. So hence, having said that, there is, however, one still underlying question mark, and that is to do with the metabolic dysregulation, whether or not it is indeed going to be permanent or not, remains dependent, I believe, under my own humble opinion and my own insight, other confounding factors, the most biggest of which is the fact that, once again, to remind readers once more, due to the draconian mandates as such that I have not been able to resume full training episodes as I've actually been disclosing back since the very first video all along. So this lack of full training episode have been, I believe, to be the very first biggest confounding marker that may explain this higher glucose readings, in which thereby, consequently, speculating me to believe, or led me to believe as such that it, there is indeed a faster rate of gluconeogenesis. However, keep in mind, there's also another confounding factor that may serve some explanation as to why behind this higher glucose readings. Keeping in mind that I am a psychoketogenic practitioner myself amidst themes and context of inaccessibility at only strategically allowing carbohydrate intake on certain days, keeping in mind that due to the fact that, once again, the fitness training episodes not being fully maintained, therefore my carbohydrate allowance days have been somewhat shortened, and thus I have not been taking any insulin-mimicking agents. Hence, I am pretty much letting my own body, my metabolism, to simply speak for itself, to pretty much give its own permission to actually to see if it can respond to anything without the use of these insulin-mimicking agents. And so, keeping that in mind, that could also be the reason why the faster glucose readings, of course, it seems to be a little bit on the higher side. And I should also mention that this has been what I've also admitted throughout my prior annual Food for Thoughts, as such that throughout summer seasons, I have been experiencing much faster, much higher incidences of higher glucose readings. However, as the season cools down, I have been actually experiencing the almost polar opposite. I have experienced, for anyone who's actually curious, as such that I have actually survived hypoglycemic readings as low as under 3 millimolars, or even as low as 2.7 millimolars. And that was me still amidst everyday general stress, anxiety, and once again, semi-depression, mental state of depression throughout all the years of, again, living under structural stress, involuntarily structural violence, the sociological stress that's attached to it, the stigma, the the amount of structural obligations that one has to actually jump through the hoops. Once again, not a video to rant about these things, but for those who are who reside in Australia and for those who can actually relate over what it's like to be involuntarily tied to institutionalization, to what we know so far as welfare programs, then you can pretty much empathize, hopefully, with my circumstance. That is, higher protein intake, dietary calcium, in which, of course, will be coming from mainly the saturated fats variety, but still keeping the fat ratio intake between low carbohydrate days to, so say, no more than 50 to 55%, whilst leveraging on the higher protein intake levels to maintain immunity as well as to maintain overall, overall physiological, and as well as to help with my own satiety levels. And this, that is actually quite an important finding. And then next, when it comes to the refeed days, or what I call the huge calorific refeed days, have been pretty much reduced to almost how shall we say this, not even a full day worth of eating. There's also another emphasis that I've been taking, and that is omega-3 fatty acids from salmon fish intakes. Now, this can be, unfortunately, quite a huge expense, because seafood in general is and can be quite a luxury. However, I believe that there is still some good merit, I believe, especially given the need for us to maintain all of our pro-inflammatory cytokines in check. So that's that. Peanut butter, as very indulgent on its own, still nevertheless remains some degree of caution to be taken care of, to be considered, because of the fact that it may also because of the fact that it contains various phytic acids and the various mineral chelators and the inhibitors in which this sadly will inhibit all the minerals that I'm trying to emphasize, in particular calcium. So that's just one strategy that I've been doing just out of my own, for my own sake. So whether or not this is constituting as a objective panacea remains up to individual's own indemnity. For anyone to therefore, please by all means self-journal yourself critically and thoroughly. And for those of you who wish to know more about how I do that, please, by all means, I invite you to take a look at my earlier videos on the tutorial, the usage, and the guidelines surrounding self-journaling. And or prior to that, I've actually labeled it as self-inquiry journaling tool by clicking on the links above and or below in the description. First of all, let me just say that I'm grateful and thank you to all of you, who actually express many thanks and well wishes. And I also therefore would like to say exactly the same thing for all of you out there who express such kind and empathetic gestures. There are, however, frownful remarks, especially those coming from, as per nobody's surprise, the anti-group of collectives and or individuals, so to speak, the naturalists, so to speak. Let me just try to disclaim myself once more. I am with you. I truly do. I have and always been an anti. That is correct. I have always been an anti. But just wait until your very own country, your very own government, tries to slowly erode your rights bit by bit. And you may think that you have contingencies. I can live with this for a while. Yeah, don't worry. I have something else in the meantime that keeps me afloat. But wait, what if the government will take that contingency away from you, restrict your everyday movements, restrict your social movement, mobility, access, to the point whereby you are even no longer to safely go out and reunite with your family members in a dining setting, unless if you are double dosed or at least you must show your vaccine passport and or immunization evidence and whatnot. And you may say, oh, don't worry, I can always resume my fitness training elsewhere. The gym is not necessary. Okay, I want to agree with you. 100%. I sincerely want to agree with you. But wait until you can no longer be able to perform the same routine movements that you were once been programmed to in your day-to-day routines. Imagine if the government is now restricting, once again, your access, structuring your access, structuring your privilege to no longer access this venue, unless if you're double dose vaccinated, to the point whereby you have to forgo your gym membership or put on hold for suspension for however long that takes until you are double dose vaccinated. Few, but quite concerning questions have been raised against me, as such that I have not been completely transparent in the way that I have been suspected for not been taking the actual Novavax vaccine. Well, I'm going to present to you the following two evidences. The first of which is the Gmail appointment of my very first dose. You can clearly see the time of the day, the brand name, Novavax, which is the technically it is branded as Novavax. I hope I actually pronounced that correctly. Of course, every confidential and non-disclosure details have been blurred out, of course, for the sake of courtesy. Here's another evidence. My entire immunization history record. This is taken and registered to the Australian government. Once we're good, then we can all be happy. And for me to advance this conversation. Once again, I'm just trying to put things into perspectives. I am with you. I really do. I am as anti as anyone who are under oppression against this authoritarian draconian measures. I really take no pleasure at all. So hence, having said that, to all of you, the shouters, the virtue signalers, keep everything amidst your own selves. There is no need for you to raise your moral pitchforks against any other who likewise wish to remain within their own scientific anonymity, scientific autonomy, scientific privacy, and therefore his or her own scientific authenticity. Just wait until you are forced to choose the lesser of evils. It is not a matter of how, it is a question of when. So signing up, my name is Andrew, and I sincerely hope that this second week of vlog journaling update will serve you and our other readers and viewers some noteworthy insights once again over my progress. But please, in the meantime, I highly encourage anyone to actually visit my accompanying blog article, by which I will try to keep a 7-day written journal update in written form, trying to disclose for any side effects and or insights, if any, noteworthy for your reading and contemplation and for your own adding to the food for thoughts repository. Once again, this is not meant to be an objective panacea over the fact that I am trying to simply fearmonger or the fact that I am simply trying to inform someone objectively and linearly on what to do. Such I am only simply sharing my own N=1 insight. Nothing more, nothing less. So please, leave your comments and thoughts down below. And thank you once again for partaking your thoughts and our discussion amidst the internet's least visited independent thoughts in wellness and decentralized nutritional science and experiences. Let us raise lateral dialogues amidst these difficult times down in the comment section below. And please, as always, keep it civil, learn for yourself, keep for yourself, and of all things, live it forward. Thank you for watching.